Welcome to Full Steam Ahead, a podcast about Purdue. After a brief hiatus, it is great to be back with all of you on the pod. And what better way to swing things off than with my friend and your Purdue baseball head coach, Greg Goff. Coach, welcome back to the podcast. How you doing?
Man, I'm doing great, Adam. Great to be back. Glad you got rolling. I love how that intro was. Swing you back into it. Let's go.
Good, you caught my pun there.
I got it, baby. I got it.
That's awesome. Hey, I can't think of a better way. Coach, you're such a great guy. I've loved getting to know you over the last few years. So it's great to have you back on the podcast and talk some Purdue baseball.
Well, I'm excited to be here. As you know, we open up Friday. So it's exciting time. And there's no better place I'd rather be with was start my Monday morning with you.
That's awesome, man. I appreciate that. And it's hard to believe baseball season's upon us if you're in Indiana and step outside. It's pretty cold. But you guys are going to Texas, so I might try to sneak on the bus with you guys and head down there with you.
Come on. Come on. I tell you what, we're excited and looking forward to it. We leave Wednesday. You know, our administration has been so great for us to allow us to go down a day early because normally we don't get outside, you know, up here this time of year. But Mother Nature and the good Lord has blessed us with a wonderful spring so far. We've been outside a few times, going over to Lowe Stadium here in town, and the folks at Lafayette have been awesome. John Miner and those guys over there have allowed us to come over and get outside a few times and catch some fly balls, Adam. We need to get outside. So it's been a really good spring, but we're excited about an opportunity getting down to Texas.
Awesome. I look forward to talking about the season here in a few minutes. Before we jump into that, I want to talk about couple other things to catch up on. Of course, this past weekend you had your fan fest, and then the week before your first pitch dinner. Talk about those couple events and how successful they've been and why they're important for the program.
Well, they really are. We've been so blessed, Adam, to you know, our first pitch dinner sold out last week, which was awesome. We had people show up at the door with a sold out crowd. We had at a table. So, you know, and a good friend of mine, Coach Keith Madison, was our guest speaker. I worked for him for 4 years. Longtime head coach at University of Kentucky, gave us a great message to kind of start off the year, and had a lot of positive feedback about that. And then this, you know, this past weekend we had Fan Fest, had almost 500 people come through. And again, those are really, really important things for me. I love this community. I love Purdue. And anytime you can give back and have opportunities for our players to give back and do those types of things, I think it's really important. And we really pride ourselves on the community service that we do with our players and our program. And just those two things are really, really important for us.
That's awesome. I love that. And, you know, speaking of community service and giving back, of course, in the fall, too, you have a couple events then, like bring schmucks like me up in there to try to hit a baseball out of the infield. And of course, your Halloween event too, which I think is really cool out there at Alexander Field. I don't know if there's, you know, to add on to your previous answer, but to talk about those things too.
Well, it's important. It's fun to have you guys come and you know, break a little bread and eat some lunch, mm-hmm. and then have a chance for me to go down on the field and throw BP to you. You know, it's just like a bunch of kids out there. You know, yes. It's just so much fun to have everybody come out there and just have a good time. To be honest with you, yeah. and just get people to get on Alexander Field. And you know what an awesome facility that we have, and what fun we have. There's a lot of bats that get thrown around out there, man. It's awesome. It's awesome. One of my funnest days in the fall, having all you guys to come out and do that. And then, you know, we make the lineup. I don't know if you made the lineup or not this year. But we love making a lineup with you guys and getting, having some fun, you know, that on with social media. And then, mm-hmm. you know, we have a wonderful Halloween game that our players dress up and our coaches dress up. And, again, mm-hmm. You know, I think we ran out of candy twice this year. So it's, you know, again, I think it's awesome, that, we can open our house up to the community and get folks involved in our program.
That's really cool. And if anybody didn't see the pictures out the go way back on Twitter, but Coach Goff made a great Gru this year from Despicable Me, for anybody who's familiar with that. That was awesome. Oh, man. Well, I did make the lineup, you know, not to brag, but that.
Yeah, that's good. That's good.
So fun. I didn't know if I would this year. I struggled hitting the ball, but it is such a fun event. I look forward to that every fall. So thank you for including people like me in that event. So
that's awesome.
A couple other things too, just that, you know, you see out in the community. I just want to get your reaction to that. And, you know, of course you had, I think, an event maybe a week or two ago where, you know, Zach Edey's out there throwing pitches, and then you watch a Purdue women's basketball game and Coach Gerald's is wearing a Purdue baseball jersey. Your reaction when you see things like that?
Well, I love it. You know, I think we have such a tremendous athletic department here, Adam, to be honest with you, led by Mike Bobinski. I think he does a great job of intertwining us together as a coaching staff. We support one another through text messages and going by and seeing Katie and coaches, you know, throughout the athletic department, I think is really special. And that's why I love here at Purdue. We got such a quality group of people. It makes me better every day, to be honest with you. I'm so fortunate to be a part of this staff and to be here at Purdue. And then to have Zach come over last week, and man, that was so much fun. I tell you, that's the first time I had a chance to meet him personally, spend 4 or 5 minutes with him. And, I mean, my goodness, what an amazing young man. What a great representative for Purdue, Purdue basketball. And, man, we had so much fun with that big guy. I don't know. I got so many text messages. Is this guy really going to pick? It was awesome. It was awesome. He was great with our players. And I'm so happy for him in the year that he's having and Coach Painter and the boys are having.
Yeah. And you're going to try to recruit him, throw some pitches this spring?
Hey, I tell you what, that big rascal was bringing it from down here. He was on top of it. I tell you, it was fun. He did tell me that he'd like to come out and do a pitch and do that for us as well. That's cool. So, hope those guys will continue to do well and finish strong.
That's awesome. And just to add to what you said, it's so cool, you know, just from my perspective, seeing the support from other programs for other programs up there when you're watching other games or on social media, just seeing, you know, soccer team making cookies for the volleyball team and coaches tweeting about other programs and you see them at the games. I think that is something special about Purdue. And I think that is really cool just to add on to what you said. So
no doubt.
Another thing I want to jump on real quick before we jump into this season, just want to flash back to last year and just that historical start for you guys, you know, starting the season off 15-0 in the top 20. As you look back on last season, just how special was that moment for you guys, for you and for the program?
Well, I think it really, you know, turned, you know, got things going where we wanted to, you know, really my first recruiting class last year. And so, you know, we just continued to build towards a winning program here and doing some things to win the Big Ten and things like that. So I thought it was amazing. I was sitting there looking at it. I mean, you know, I can't beat my daughter 15 times in a round of basketball. You know, I mean, it was amazing what those guys were able to do. Just so many different opportunities last year in that win streak that players really, you know, stood out and stepped up for our team and played really, really well. And so, you know, really, this year is our kind of our motto is finish. You know, last year got off to a great start, had a couple of guys get hurt and didn't finish the way we wanted to. We want to start the way we did, Adam, this past year, and then we want to better finish that and put together a complete, you know, 35 or 40 win season and get ourselves into a position to be in a regional type team.
Sure. And the things like that, you know, the national tension that came with that as well.
Yep.
Are those things that help the program as far as recruiting, confidence, all of the above?
Yes, it's huge. And I mean, that's part of, you know, getting the program where I wanted to go, to be honest with you. And it takes time. It takes time. If you want to build it right, it takes time to do those types of things. And so I'm just really excited about, you know, our second recruiting class was better than our first. And I mean, Coach Rooney and Coach Marks and those guys have did a tremendous job on the road. I mean, people don't realize how much time they're, you know, spending on the road away from their families and things of that nature. And so, I'm really appreciative of those guys and what they do. And, you know, just, again, you know, looks at like the recruiting class we brought in for this year. And so we're really excited about the future of our program and the direction that we're going. It's a lot of fun.
That's awesome. And let's talk about some of those preparations now. The season that we already talked about starts Friday down in Texas against Holy Cross. Just talk about how the preparation is going. You mentioned getting to get out a few times over at Loeb and just how you feel like the team's coming together so far.
Well, I think we've had some good preparation. This is probably, since I've been here, probably the best early spring. We've been out a number of times so far. And as anything, you know, baseball, you know, getting outside that depth perception in the outfield, seeing a ball live instead of inside, you know, Adam, is really important. So we've had great preparation. I think our guys are ready to go. We had a couple guys banged up. We're hoping to get back on the field here this weekend. But we're really excited and really, really, you know, we have a lot of guys back from last year. 7 of the 9 hitters are back from last year's lineup. So, you know, we finished second in the league last year in offense. And we feel like we've added some other pieces of the puzzle as well. So we're really, really thankful for those guys that are returning and really excited about the guys we brought in.
Yeah, and talk about some of those strengths. I know you're aggressive on the bases and like the be aggressive. I think what the fastest team on dirt or whatever. I think you guys like talk about some of your strengths, and then after that, just you know, some of the things you are you know wanting to see how it plays out in real time this weekend, sure. And hoping to maybe improve on.
Right. Well, we do. We talk about being the fastest show on dirt all the time, and you know, last year we stole over 100 something bases. And, you know, we like to put pressure on people. We don't like to sit back and try to score, you know, four or five runs in one inning. That's nice. But, you know, like I told our team yesterday in practice, like, you know, I want an offense built that we can score when the wind's blowing in, when the wind's blowing out, when it's a cold day, when it's a warm day. Like for us to get to that 35 to 40 win plateau, you've got to have different ways to score. And so some days we'll have to run an offense. We'll have to bunt or hit and run. And things like that. And then some days we'll be able to just swing it away. And so we want to make sure we're able to accumulate and have different ways that we can do that. And that's what we can take a lot of pride in. We get hit by pitches. Getting on base is really important for us. You know, making that pitcher uncomfortable or ways that I feel like are really beneficial for us as we move forward.
Yeah. And talk about, you mentioned a lot of guys returning. Talk about some of your leaders on this team. I know you got Cam and Michael and Evan and those guys kind of back. Talk about them and any others that you're, you know, looking forward to be filling that leadership role this year.
Sure. Well, it all starts with Evan Albrecht. I mean, he's a fifth-year guy. He's been playing a bunch of games, and he's as old as I am. So, you know, he's great. You know, for him to return this year has been such a solid foundation for us. And he'll be, you know, he'll be at short again this year, and he's been there for the last 4 years. So, you know, anytime you have your shortstop, that's kind of the captain on the team out there having it, it's really important. Michael Bolton's another guy, been here for 4 years, has played a lot the last 3 years, was an all-conference guy 2 years ago, is our leadoff guy again this year. He kind of sets the tempo, you know, and so we're excited about having him back. He'll move to center field this year where he played left last year. Cam Thompson, another guy that we have coming back. C.J. Valdez was an all-conference DH last year. He's back. Paul Tate's a guy that's been playing ever since he got out of high school, and he'll be back. And so, you know, we have a lot of guys returning, you know, from the offensive side of things. We've got the biggest question mark for me is really the pitching aspect of it. With losing Jackson Smeltz and Wyatt Wendell to the draft, and a few other guys, Landon Wines. That was really great guy, the bullpen force. We lost a lot of innings. So that's really right now is what our biggest question mark is. As you say, going into the season is where our pitching is and, you know, how well we do there.
Gotcha. And you mentioned, you know, your last two recruiting classes that you're really excited about, especially this one coming in this year. Talk about those guys, any of those that you might expect or hope to make an immediate impact this year?
Well, we got some guys, especially on the mound, that we have. Jonathan Blackwell is a transfer from Coastal. He's a left-hand pitcher. You'll probably see him, you know, in the top four rotation at some point. He's did really well for us. Aaron Suval and Davis Pratt are two guys that have had really exceptional junior college careers that you'll see a lot of those guys. You know, those guys are really competitive, Adam, to be honest with you. And really, I think it's going to really solidify our pitching staff to where it needs to be. With those guys. So Connor Cascanet's a catcher that we brought in, had a really phenomenal junior college career that we're really excited about. And, you know, I think it's going to add a little more punch there to the middle of the order. So there's a lot of new guys. I think 19 new guys, 21 returners and 19 new guys to make this team.
That's great. I think that's a great balance to have, right? You have some older guys that have been here and then some new guys to help rejuvenate and maybe push the older guys to keep going, right?
That's right. And as you know, competition is a great thing. And, you know, that's the one thing that we've tried to work towards as we've taken over here is just the competition, the depth that we have. And, you know, that's what I told our team yesterday. You know, I want my job to be tough making a lineup out every day.
Yeah. You made the comment earlier about, you know, the goal to win the Big Ten last year. I know you made the Big Ten tournament.
Yep.
Can you talk about expectations and goals for this team for this season?
Well, that's what we talk about. You know, that's why I stayed here. That's why I didn't leave. I think we can win the Big Ten here. I think we can be a team that's at the top of the Big Ten and getting into a regional. And my goal is to host a regional one day here at Alexander Field. I think we can do all those things. You can't win the Kentucky Derby with some mules. You got to have the thoroughbreds, right? And so, you know, we continue to build this on really good players. And, you know, the players are the reasons why we're having the success that we are, and really the standard that we set. You know, our goal this year is to win the Big Ten and have opportunity to play in the postseason this year.
That's awesome. You know, we touched on it briefly, but just how excited you guys are to get down to Texas and spend some time in the South over the next month or so, where it's a little bit warmer, play some baseball outside.
Well, we're ready. You know, these guys have worked hard. I mean, I tell you what, they have committed themselves. We talked about it from day one. We are training to win a championship. Every day, we're training to win a championship. And they did a great job in the weight room. They did a tremendous job in the classroom this past fall with a 3.1 GPA. They did their job in the community service, and now it's time to take it to the field, man. I'm fired up, Adam. I'll tell you what, I'm so excited to have an opportunity. I told these guys, and I told the people at the first pitch dinner, there's not a place I'd rather be at Purdue, and there's not a team I'd want to coach than these guys right here, buddy. And I tell you what, I can't wait for that guy to say play ball on Friday.
That's awesome. And of course, you know, hopefully the weather gets a little bit better in March. You got, I think, 3 home games in March, and just talk about how exciting is that, you know, eventually get back up here to play a game in Alexander Field, and then also just sell a game for somebody who's maybe never been out to watch you guys play.
Well, you know, we feel like we have one of the best facilities in the country, to be honest with you. Our grounds crew is tremendous. They do a tremendous job. Our facility is awesome. I think there's, you know, every seat in there is a great place. Now we have protective netting all the way around for the most part, so it's fan friendly. And it's a great place to play. You're right there on top of the players. You get a chance to really, you know, see their personalities come out a little bit and things of that nature. But, you know, for people that's never seen us play, you're going to see somebody that's with a lot of passion, a lot of energy. You know, we pride ourselves on you know, hard 90s down to first base and playing hard and outworking people, putting pressure on people. You know, it's not going to be a boring sit back and let's see what happens. We're going to take it to folks. And I think they'll really enjoy the way we compete, how we handle ourselves, and hopefully how we represent Purdue.
That's awesome. And you still got those Charter brothers calling those games up there?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, I saw them last week up at the first pitch dinner, man. It's awesome to have those guys, and what tremendous assets they are from the experience and the knowledge they have for Purdue baseball.
They really do. It was great having them on the podcast last year, just getting an opportunity to feature them and their story as well. They do a great job. It's great when, you know, a lot of those games aren't televised. If I'm at work or at home, I can listen to the radio and listen to those guys calling the game. So
yeah, they're awesome. Yep. They're awesome. They said do such a great job.
Awesome. Coach, as we're wrapping up, anything else that you want to add?
No, again, I just want to thank everyone for all their support they've given us through the Fan Fest and First Pitch Dinner and all the support. And I just want to I challenge everybody to come out and watch us play this spring. We're excited about starting our season, and really think you'll see a program that's continuing to build towards winning the championship here and doing all the things right.
That's awesome, Coach. Can't wait for Friday. Can't wait to be
pumping
the jersey out for everybody.
That's right. That's right. Yeah, you have to get those new black uniforms that we have. Did you see those?
Yes, those are sweet. Yes.
Oh, my goodness. It's awesome.
That's awesome, Coach. Well, it's so great catching up with you. So excited for you guys this year. I know you guys are going to be very successful on the field. And like you mentioned, already successful off the field. So keep up the good work up there, Coach. It's been so great just to get to know you over these last few years. And I appreciate your friendship.
Awesome, Adam. Have a great day. God bless.
You too, man. Take care. Boiler up.
All right. Boiler up.